Beloved in the Lord, Sora Maria Tripha has been called by the Lord of the Church into the office of the Holy Ministry of the Word and Sacraments. He has been prepared for this ministry by careful study and prayer. He has been examined and declared ready and prepared to undertake this sacred responsibility, and by the guidance of God the Holy Spirit, he has in the Church's usual order been called to be a pastor working in Romania. According to apostolic practice, he is now presented to be ordained and consecrated to this office established by God.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Through the diversity of tongues you gather together the nations in the unity of
suffer, and on the third day rise from the dead, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. And to Timothy, St. Paul wrote, "Do not neglect the gift you have, which has given you, which was given you by prophecy when the council of elders laid their hands on you. Practice these things, devote yourself to them, so that all may see your progress. Keep a close watch on yourself and on the teaching. Persist in this, for by doing so you will save both yourself and your hearers." And again, St. Paul writes, "This is how one should regard us, as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required of stewards that they be found trustworthy." Such is the confidence that we have through Christ toward God. Not that we ourselves are, not that we are sufficient in ourselves to claim anything as coming from us, but our sufficiency is from God. And hear what Holy Scripture says concerning the strength and promise God gives to those in the office of the Holy Ministry. St. Paul writes, "Continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. Dear brother in Christ, the Lord grant that you receive and keep these words in your heart, so that you may be strengthened and encouraged in your labors. God gathers his church by and around his holy gospel, and thereby also grants it growth and increase according to his good pleasure. That this may be done, he has established the office of the holy ministry into which you have been called by the church, and are now to be ordained and consecrated by prayer and the laying on of hands. In the presence of this congregation and before our Lord God, to whom you must give an account now and at the last day, I now ask you. Sorry, do you acknowledge that the Lord has called you through his church into the ministry of word and sacrament?
I do.
Do you believe and confess the canonical books of the Old and New Testaments to be the inspired word of God and the only infallible rule of faith and practice?
Yes, I believe and confess the canonical scripture to be the inspired word of God and the only infallible rule of faith and practice.
Do you believe and confess the three ecumenical creeds, namely the Apostles, the Nicene, and the Athanasian creeds, as faithful testimonies to the truth of the Holy Scriptures, and do you reject all the errors which they condemn?
Yes, I believe and confess the three ecumenical creeds, because they are in accord with the Word of God. I also reject all the errors they condemn.
Do you confess the unaltered Augsburg Confession to be a true exposition of Holy Scripture and a correct exhibition of the doctrine of the Evangelical Lutheran Church? And do you confess that the apology of the Augsburg Confession, the small and large catechisms of Martin Luther, the small fault articles, the treatise on the power and primacy of the Pope, and the formula of Concord, as these are contained in the Book of Concord, are also in agreement with this one scriptural faith?
Yes, I make these confessions my own because they are in accord with the Word of God.
Do you promise that you will perform the duties of your office in accordance with these confessions, and that all your preaching and teaching and your administration of the sacraments will be in conformity with Holy Scripture and with these confessions?
Yes, I promise with the help of God.
Will you faithfully instruct both young and old in the chief articles of Christian doctrine? Will you forgive the sins of those who repent? And will you promise never to divulge the sins confessed to you? Will you minister faithfully to the sick and dying? And will you demonstrate to the church a constant and ready ministry centered in the gospel? Will you admonish and encourage the people to live to a lively confidence in Christ and in holy living?
Yes, I promise with the help of God.
Finally, will you honor and adorn the office of the holy ministry with a holy life? Will you be diligent in the study of Holy Scripture and the confessions? And will you be constant in prayer for those under your pastoral care?
I will. The Lord help me to the power and grace of his Holy Spirit.
Please be. Peace be to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you. And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Sorum Horia Tripha. I ordain and consecrate you to the office of the holy ministry of the word and sacraments in the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord Jesus pour out on you his Holy Spirit for this office and work, that you may faithfully preach the gospel and administer the sacraments. Amen.
Dávej pozor na své jednání i na své učení. Buď v tom vytrvalý. Tak posloužíš ke spasení nejen sobě, ale i svým posluchačům. Žehnej ti všemohoucí Bůh, Otec i Syn i Duch Svatý. Amen.
Dumnezeu să vă binecuvânteze, dragă soare Maria.
Brother Soren, for you I've chosen the words we heard earlier this afternoon as Paul met with the Ephesian elders and charged them, keep watch over yourself and over the flock over whom the Holy Spirit has made you an overseer. Acts 20:28.
Let us all pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be
thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.